Hey guys, welcome back to another weekly vlog. This week's vlog is going to be a cleaning vlog because the apartment is in such a mess, and I really just wanted to use this vlog to kind of do a little spring cleaning. I mean, it's still very much winter, but I just wanted to get a head start on spring cleaning because one, it makes me feel so much better and lighter and just in a better headspace. So if you yourself are looking to do some cleaning and you needed a little motivation, I really hope this video could be that for you because my space is in such a mess, and honestly, it's been messing with my head so much. So I'm excited to finally jump into like organizing, cleaning, laundry. Oh my gosh, so much laundry to do, but it's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. We're gonna get through this together, all right? So enjoy the video, enjoy the vibes, enjoy the music. I'm gonna try to make it as relaxing as I possibly can. And again, I really hope this motivates you if you're also in need of a little spring cleaning yourself. So enjoy the video. Starting with the living room, we're gonna take the covers off of this couch and throw them in the wash. The name of this couch is the Harlanda. It's from IKEA, very affordable. I'm obsessed with this couch. At first I purchased it as like a temporary type of thing, but I'm obsessed with this couch. Basically, I'm just removing the seats and the cushion covers, and they are so dirty, you guys. I'm actually very happy that you can't see how gross they are on the camera, because in person, so bad. So I'm just gonna remove them all and throw them in the wash. Now, a commonly asked question of mine, which is so surprising, is how do I wash my white clothes? So I use Tide, and with the cushion covers, I'm gonna put two pods in here, and I'm just gonna add a little bit of Clorox bleach. Now, I don't have the liquid kind. I only have the one that you use to surface clean, which I don't even know if you should put that on clothes, but I did it, and my cushion covers were fine. So I used this spray one here. It's what I used to clean like my bathroom and stuff, but it ended up working out just fine, so. And I always get asked what settings I use for my machine to wash my white stuff. So I always just use the weights option, and I always adjust based on the load. I always do hot water and normal rinse. So that's pretty much what I do. So while the covers are being washed, I'm just gonna tackle the coffee table. This one is from Amazon. It's just a very simple black coffee table and very affordable too. So I'm just gonna give it a really good wipe down with this Method glass cleaner, which isn't supposed to be this color, but I mixed it with Windex because yeah. Anyways, just gonna wipe the table down and just put everything back on. This table gets really messy throughout the week, like really messy. So these are my Elle magazines with Viola Davis. I love her and really wanted to support her cover. I got these from Elle Brazil. Yeah. So I'm just gonna put everything back on and then we're gonna move on. Now on to the bathroom. Aside from a few little things out of place, it wasn't that bad in here, but first thing I wanted to tackle is taking down my shower curtain because I actually got hair dye on here and it was just stained for weeks. And it was really just messing with my feng shui. Every time I would film in here, I would have to hide the spot. And I was also holding off because this shower curtain was kind of expensive. It was like $39 from Target. So I was really trying to make it last as long as I could. But that's it, girl. Now we're gonna tackle the toilet. And I just used the Clorox bleach and then I used this like toilet bowl cleaner. And for those of you wondering why I'm not wearing gloves, I just feel like because I'm cleaning my own apartment, I don't really need to wear gloves. Plus, but definitely when you're cleaning with such strong chemicals, you probably should protect your hands. I just feel like for me personally, it done gone bad already. Okay, I've been doing this for years and my hands are just very dry and just, they mash up, but it's all right. And for the bathtub, I use the same things. I just use the Clorox bleach just to kind of spray it all over. But this green thing, it's called the soft scrub something. Once you spray this, it kind of like foams a little bit and it lifts up every soap grime there is, and it just leaves your bathroom, your bathtub looking squeaky clean. So I really do like this, and I just allow it to soak for as long as I can. All right, day two of cleaning, and I had just gotten back from the gym and spent the entire morning shooting. So the place was a disaster, and not only that, my friend texted and said that she'll be over at my place in an hour. So I was just going mad. I was just scrambling to clean up, because one thing about me, the Jamaican in me will not allow myself to host and my place is looking like this. Shameful. So I'm just cleaning up now. I usually wash my pots in the dishwasher. I'm not even gonna front, I do. But all my pots were dirty, and this is my caraway pot set. It's very rare that all of them are dirty at once, but the previous night I hosted and I cooked, so everything was dirty. So I'm just washing my pots. I always get asked also, do I recommend my pots from Caraway? And although the tiny frying pan is starting to stick now, because that little like patch in the center does not go away. I've scoured it, I've done everything. It's not budging. That area though is sticking, so it's definitely not something I'm happy about. But overall, I do love these pots. I mean, I use them every single time I cook, and I love the quality. I love how sleek they are, and yeah, I would actually spend my own money on these because I love them so much. And the larger frying pan, there is a spot in here, but that one is able to, you know, come out. But the other one in the next pot, I don't know what's going on. But yeah, just washing my pots and gonna just dry them off right after. Now on to cleaning the stove. I have an electric stove, and at first I really was not a fan of this thing because I've cooked on like a gas stove my entire life. But one of the pros though, it's so easy to clean. So I use this Weeman glass cooktop solution here, and it comes in a kit from Amazon. This is gonna bring your stove back to like brand new condition. So I use a little sponge to kind of do a little surface clean, get rid of any food particles and stuff like that. Then I just put the solution on. I'm not exactly sure how little or how much you're supposed to use, but I used about this each time. And then I'm gonna go in with the little brushy thing that came in the kit. Wait one second. I'm gonna use this first to get rid of any particles that are stuck. So any things like that that's difficult to come off, you might want to do this part first before you put the solution on. And once that's done, we're gonna go in with the brush. And honestly, just go back and forth until everything is gone. And it's just gonna give your stovetop, like your electric stovetop, that really beautiful shine, like how you found it. And once that's done, I switch over to a paper towel or some sort of like rag, up to you. And this is where I'm gonna go in and like really start to buff it in, and it's gonna look so good after. But I absolutely love cleaning the stove because it just looks beautiful and brand spanking new. Also, when I clean my stove, I like to take the knobs off and also wash those, and also make sure that I clean the body of the stove, not just the stove top. I'm gonna go in with my Weeman stainless steel cleaner wipes. I'm just gonna wipe down the surface of the stove here, the handles, the knobs, everything. And I love this stainless steel wipe because it doesn't like leave your stove like smeary or anything like that. It's really, really good. I actually got this tip from Jackie Ina, because her home is beautiful, and this is what she uses to clean her stainless steel. I'm actually curious what song I'm singing here, so let's hear. LOL. Anyways, let's move on. So I have my makeup brushes here in the washing machine. This is how I clean my brushes. Now, I wouldn't necessarily recommend this technique because it does ruin your brushes over time. I have noticed that, but I'm just way too lazy to do the individual hand washing thing. So this is what I do. But I removed it from the wash and now we're gonna lay them out to dry. And this is a deep cleaning type of, you know, vibe. So everything is getting clean. Brushes, I'm wiping down everything. So yeah, let's lay these out to dry so I can move on to other things. As I'm drying my makeup brushes, I'm going to tackle my makeup cart here. This is how I store my makeup. I don't have lots of makeup, but I do have a couple products here and there. So I'm going to just take everything out of these acrylic containers and I'm going to wash the container and also just wipe down every piece of makeup and also go through the makeup products that I no longer wear or might be expired, because a lot of these I've had for some time. Because you guys know I use the same like 12 products every day. I don't really deviate, so I have a lot of product just like sitting. So I'm just gonna take everything out of the cart. We're gonna wipe things down and we're gonna just wipe the cart down itself as well. I'm gonna spray it with my all-purpose cleaner here. I'm gonna just wipe it to get all the makeup stains out and remove every single product and then put things back in order, of course. Also, as I'm reorganizing, I'm making sure to get rid of products that I no longer use or need. That way I don't have unnecessary clutter, you know? Update, so we've kind of finished laundry in the room and this is what my bedroom is looking like so far. I'm kind of like not happy with like how it looks right now. I kind of want to make it more, I don't know, I love the vibe like by the window, the plant, the vases, the vases. I mean, I just want to like get everything sorted in here, but I just feel like I don't know what to do exactly yet, but at least my laundry's done and that's a plus. So this is the closet, guys. I don't know if you've seen the closet since I moved to this apartment. Well, you might have seen it the day that I moved in, but I don't think I've shown it since. Special, I mean, it is a very small walk-in closet. At least I can come in here. I have my fragrances down here, you can't see, but fragrances, but I kind of want to put this in my bedroom and bring my dresser in here. It's going to definitely give me a lot less space to work with, but I don't let my dresser be in the bedroom because the bedroom is so small. Yada, 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 complaints, complaints. So I'm going to take my fragrances off of here, put them on the bed temporarily, and I'm going to try to put this in my bedroom. Let's just figure it out. And then we need to organize my clothes. So much to do, but yeah, let's jump into the closet. Let's tackle the closet. So I've had these shoe shelves for such a long time. I really do like them, but they're just becoming like way less functional. In terms of, I can't really see all my shoes, so I kind of want to
figure out a way to just make my shoes more visible.
In total, I have like 6 shelves. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Then over there, they're like nooked in the, like lodged in the corner.
Like something like this. And for reference, I got these from Amazon.
Okay, so I finished with the closet overnight. I spent the majority of the night just trying to organize it a lot better. So let me just show you guys around. All right, so when you first walk into the closet, the first thing you see is this little acrylic table to the left. And I just have all my fragrances on here. I did organize my fragrances by fragrance house. So perfumed the Marley is here. I have the Lena, I'm sorry, and I forgot the names of these two, but yeah. I really want to add another one, the one that recently came out, but I am still thinking about it because I have so many fragrances that I don't even wear any longer. But yeah, next up I have the Jo Malone's, the YSL Lieb, and at the back I have this Hermes one, my Chanel Chance, my Le Labo. Yeah, my Le Labo, my Baccarat, which is like almost finished. I mean, I got this like so long ago and I'm just now about to finish it. And then just some other fragrances here. My Louboutin one, just some body creams that I like to layer when I wear my perfumes, and just some newer stuff. And these I got in PR, the Prada, the Jimmy Choo, and the Mizinger. So yeah, just like my perfumes to the left. And then here's my closet. So it's organized, like color coded. So yeah, so all of my black purses, some are up here, some are in like storage containers, which I have down here, because I do wear some bags more than others and some I don't even wear at all. So some are in the bins. Clothes. So I have a lot of black clothes. You guys know I love to wear black, so lots of black clothing, some black and white stuff. My creams, my pure whites, my little bit of color I have. I'm very intentional about the colors that I wear now, so I really do love rust against my skin. This red, I really want to get rid of this, but I figured I'd wear it. It might be a spring moment, so I have it here. Taupes and this beautiful shade of purple. I love this shade of purple, like absolutely love. This is actually from Monroe Steel and Sonia's, I believe her name is Sonia, their clothing line. I really love this dress, it's so flattering. I wore it once before, but I'm definitely gonna get a couple more wears out of it because I love the material, like actually love the, can you guys see? Like I actually love the fabric of this, like really, really nice. And then over here, just have like my navies and this denim set. Denim is definitely back in style, so I have some couple like denim on denim moments that I want to wear. This I do need to get fitted to my body because it's a little bit big, the top is. So yeah. And then extra hangers because I got rid of so many clothing items. So I did really, really good. I did a really nice declutter. And then for purses, I just have like my nude and white bags over the white section, silver bag, totes. Yeah, just some bags that I haven't really worn yet, but you'll see them soon. And then just storage. I have storage on top of storage, you guys. I have bags, I have sweatshirts, I have just random things in these bins, but these bins comes in so clutch. They're from IKEA, they're sleek, they fit in like tiny spaces, and I just love them. I was thinking of turning them the other way, but I love that I do have some storage down here, which I also have some additional thing. This dress is from Dish. It's a really nice vacation dress, so that's there. And then over here, I just have my shoes. On top, I have my boots. The fact that these keep folding over is like really annoying me. Like really annoying me. Like please just stand up tall. But it's kind of like a softer like leather, so definitely needs a little boot holder in there. So I'm gonna order one because I really do want it to be upright. And then I have some denim, not denim, but pants over here. So my skirts, because I'm definitely into skirts a lot lately, which is so different for me, you know, that sort of thing. And then over here I have a majority of my shoes. I do have some shoes at the house, and then this is just what I have here because these are very appropriate for like New York, I think. So booties, platforms, sandals, just regular heels for night outs and things of that nature. So yeah, that's pretty much it for the closet. So really, really simple. Down here, just a shoebox, and just I had some additional shelving, like these ones. I could have stacked this higher, and I might eventually, but I really wanted to put them here for additional storage because I have all my sunglasses in here. I have my jewelry box down here, so I really like having additional storage. But I definitely think I achieved what I wanted to achieve, a functional like closet space. So even though it's small, I may do with little things to kind of add, you know, a little bit of functionality. Of course, I could have installed like actual shelves in here and really did something, but because I'm not gonna be in this apartment for much longer, like, so I just wanted something temporary that would just make me happy, you know? So, yeah. So here I'm finishing up laundry. I had loads and loads of laundry to do, and I do my laundry in three separate loads. So I do, you know, like my linens, then my whites, then my darks, then my colors. It's just a lot. So I'm just folding some laundry because the bed's a mess, especially just after all those loads. And it's just me here, and it's insane how much laundry I go through. It's like, it's too much. But once I'm done with this, I'm gonna get started on unpacking my luggage from Smoky Mountains, because we've now gone and have returned home from Smoky Mountains. So yeah. So this is the bedroom, nice and clean. I could have done a better job with the bed, but it's linen, so it's very difficult to make it look really, really nice. But yeah, we're nice and clean in here. I have this bench in here from Zara Home, which I love so much. My bedside table, my eye mask from Slip, the 5-minute journal, and jewelry. I'll try not to sleep my jewelry as much anymore, so I have this little jewelry holder thing here from Majuri. And the sculpture is from CB2. You guys already saw that I cleaned the closet. I really love this mirror here. Get some light in here. So living room, this is what we're working with. I just put all my vases that I don't really know where to put them yet or what to put in them. I just have them here acting as a part of the decor, but they need to be in certain spaces. I just don't know where to put them as yet, but yeah, that's the vibe. I also have this bowl here from House of Amela on top of my Viola Davis L cover magazine. This is the frame TV, so you can put a little painting on here if you want to. My home scent right now is Suntal 26. In addition to the Jo Malone Lino Nel Vento linen spray. The coffee table is from Amazon. Magazines from El Brazil. I got the link from a TikTok girl a while back, and I just have this bowl here, just gonna throw the remote in and stuff like that. I do have this poof here. This poof I got from CB2 because this couch didn't have like a footrest area, so I just have this here. Although I kind of just lay on the couch that way anyways, I just have this here in case. This little basket, I usually have my laptop and stuff in here for when I'm editing. I usually sit on the couch as well, but I don't really need to because technically my office is right here. Desk is over here where I edit, and yeah, this is where I sit and I edit my videos in this little chair here. This chair is from CB2. It's technically a dining table chair, but my lacy is orange, so it's like not going with the aesthetic right now. But yeah, this is the office area. I do want to have my YouTube plaque. I was going to mount it, and I still might, but that's usually something I have in mind. But yeah, this is the living room area, so nice and clean. Kitchen area is nice and clean again. So we have this plant. This is a fake olive. No, this isn't fake. It's a real, but it's a dried olive branch thingy. This is a black vase. I really want to get some aesthetically pleasing hand wash and maybe like a different bottle for my dishwashing liquid. But for now, I kind of just keep these under my sink. And this is what I have by the kitchen and by the front door. It's just like this bench with all my everyday shoes that I slip into, whether it's for the gym or to run downstairs for mail or just house shoes. This is where those are. I also keep these by the door. They're what like people will wear just so to cover their shoes, my bag. All right, you've reached the end of the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed watching me clean and you found it very relaxing or you found it very motivating for your own cleaning day. So I hope you guys didn't mind too much that this vlog was a little bit different. This was just something that I really needed to do to clear my head, you know, and to just also just be in a better like clean living space because that's so necessary for my mental. Now that the place is clean, I can jump into filming a little apartment tour slash apartment update. Decor update because I have been adding little different, you know, pieces to the space and I think it looks so cute and so much like more cozy. So thanks again for watching you guys and for the support that you show me every single week. Can't thank you guys enough for just all that you do. I'm so grateful and I will see you guys next week.